It is 8:28 now on this Friday morning. We've got a special guest joining us in the Fox 44 studios. We have Secretary Sonny Perdue of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning,
Jerry. A pleasure to have you here on the show with us this morning and here in Baton Rouge. Yeah. We've got a lot to talk about and not a lot of time to talk about it in, but you are here in the capital city because you are delivering the commencement speech for the fall graduates at Southern University over on the Bluff later this morning. The first Ag Secretary to actually give that commencement speech, so thanks for being here in the capital city.
That's what I understand, 150 years, but Jared, I got here as quick as I could.
Well, thank you. Thank you for that. And I'm sure the graduates are looking forward to everything that you have to say. You know, 2019, ending a year, heading into 2020. What's your message to the graduates over at Southern University?
Well, obviously, their mascot is the Jaguars. We're going to talk about some of the characteristics of a Jaguar today, of the life skills that they've learned here at Southern, and one of our land-grant universities that we're very proud of. And they're well prepared for life. So we're going to talk about how they take those skills they've gained here and magnify them and multiply them in their life.
Absolutely, and speaking of what they do there over on the Bluff, obviously Southern University Agriculture School, you know, A&M. Speaking of agriculture, lots have been happening there across the nation and across the world, really, that has impacts here in Louisiana. We've reported on the U.S.-Mexico-Canada trade deal and how that impacts farmers here in Louisiana. They were impacted negatively, but have recently been able to get some federal funds.
Right. You know, 2019, from a weather perspective and other things, you wouldn't think rice would be flooded out. We've had tough season here in 2019, but I think we're ending up on a good note from a trade perspective. We finally have the speaker acknowledging that the USMCA is a great deal for the American economy, and hopefully we'll have that passed before they leave for Christmas break. We got some interesting news yesterday, getting close with a deal with China, which is really a big deal. But even though we're waiting on those, we did get rice into Korea as well for the first time. So that's a big deal for Louisiana farmers.
And so for Louisiana farmers who maybe hear the headlines, see the news reports of the things that are happening there in Washington, but are still feeling kind of the negative effects from what's going on in on the greater economy scale, what do you tell them?
Well, farming's tough. They know it's tough. They're resilient. And the weather risk, all those things, as well as trade disruptions, have been harmful. I think better days are ahead. I think hopefully 2019 will culminate and begin a great 2020 for the future. But that's why farmers are farmers. They're optimistic. They're hopeful. They've got the faith to put that seed in the ground every spring.
Absolutely. And something else that has been happening lately that's impacting Louisiana folks as well, changes to the SNAP program, changes to the food stamp program, more commonly known across the country, changes to the work requirements and the work eligibility that could impact about 50,000 people here in Louisiana. And what's kind of your stance on how you get through that also, you know, the growing pains?
The rules are pretty simple. We're going back to the original concept, the law that's still on the books, 1996. President Clinton signed, a majority of Senate and House Democrats voted for this bill at that time. It says if you're able-bodied, no dependents, not pregnant, and not elderly, that's from 18 to 49, if you're none of those things, we give you 120 days as a help up on food stamps, and then we want you to either be in training for a job or working 20 hours a week and for an able-bodied adult. We think in this today's economy, a booming economy, 3.5% unemployment, that the American dream is not government dependency. The American dream is a job where you go from one to a better one to a better one. And that's what we want to help people do.
And very quickly, before we let you go, you only have a couple of seconds, but talking about that and the changes, these changes don't happen overnight. They're going to take effect here in Louisiana in April. But how do you, what do you tell folks who may think that they need to start doing something now to make sure that they can still support their families?
Well, we've got a million jobs out there looking, less than a million people looking. And that's what I say, you know, go. We got education and training facilities all over Louisiana, all over the United States to help people get back into the workforce. We want them to build that economy and build themselves at the same time.
Awesome. Thank you, Secretary Sonny Perdue from the U.S. Department of Agriculture. Great to have you here in the studio and here in the capital city.